Hi, this is Jerry Jenkins. Python 3.8.0 is coming out this fall, and the beta 1 is out now. And they have a new feature that's my second favorite feature in their release, which are debug f-strings, which is actually a very simple feature I'm going to show you. You can click a link on the video description to get to where you can download information about version 3.8 beta, or you can go to python.org. Downloads tag, pre-releases, and you'll find a link to it. So let me show you that. So we go to python.org, go to downloads, and you'll see pre-releases right here, and here's the link to it. And it goes through all the versions, and down here you have download installers for Windows and Mac, and for Linux you have to build it from sources with the zipped file. So the new feature is f-strings, and so hopefully you're already familiar with f-strings. So this is a really nice feature, especially if you're logging or if you want to create strings for logging, and also if you do debug printing. So let me demo it here. So I'm going to open up my Python 3.8 that I've installed on a Mac, and let's define a variable 33. And so if you're debugging and you want to know what that is, you do an F string, and normally you can print out the variable. And it prints it out. And if you want to use this new feature, you add an equal sign, and where you add it is after the variable. So we'll just add it right after here. We'll add an equal, hit enter, and you notice it says the variable name equals 33. It also allows you to put spaces around it. So you can see it says X, and it adds spaces around the equal. You can also use the formatting codes. So if I do, let's see, something more complex, I'm going to do an expression, 1, let's see, divided by x plus 1, and we want to format that. Well, first we'll do it this way. Oops. A little typo there. So I have 1 divided by, there we go, left that off, there we go. So we have a complex expression. So it also will do an expression equals and give you the result. And now you can format that. So if I want to limit the number of decimal places, just before the end of the format area, we're going to say colon 0.4f. So that should do 4 decimal places. And there you are. And that's basically it. So hope you enjoyed this.